want to go to the doll. For sure, I will get one.
The doll museum? Oh, scary.
I want to take a picture in there. Just you and me. There.
Where?
Candy cane.
Who's going to take our picture? Looks like they're taking them somewhere.
Oh.
What's this? Dang. Oh. That's a race car. Scary.
Maybe wait now. Can you move a little bit?
Yay! Here we go.
We don't know what he was gonna say, so let's go.
I heard there's a boogeyman in there.
Yeah.
Check it out.
We're trying.
Hello, welcome to the Doll Museum.
All right.
The picture in the corner over there, sir, is a picture of her grandparents.
Oh, look at them.
He was this is a thing she's elected to make all the dolls in the museum.
Oh.
Get y'all in right quick. All of the dolls in here, and now some other people are donating some. The story about her grandparents is her grandfather was a circuit rider for the Methodist Church. And back in about 1895, he came down in this area on his little mule.
I like this one.
Across the mighty Yakin River when it was just a creek. And came into the Cool Springs community and met the Laughlin family. Well, there was a little red-headed girl.
This
too. He said, there are sinful people down here. I got to keep coming back for revivals and arbor meetings and singings on the river and things like this, you know. So he come back. It took him 3 years, but he married her.
Aww.
And then he took her back to Forsyth County. And Forsyth, at the corner of Weber Street and West Tumblesville Road, there's a little church called Mount Palmer United Methodist Church, and they helped build that church and started that church. And their tombstones are in that group.
Really?
Huh?
I've been to them somewhere.
We're up in that area.
You are. Where do you live at?
Well, right now we're in Lexington, but my wife, she's from Tobaccoville.
Yes.
And I'm from Keene.
Yes.
But we spend a lot of our time in Winston, of course, you know.
Well, of course, it's the big city.
Exactly.
I mean, they got skyscrapers and everything. The doll in the corner cabinet over there is the one they made for Grandma Lat Patterson.
Oh, look at her. Come on.
Come on in. Welcome to the office. You ready?
Yeah.
Well, ma'am, it's been nice talking
to you. Come back, and if you catch the tram underneath the Merry Christmas sign, it takes you down to the plantation house and to the blacksmith shop.
That's where that is?
That's where that's going.
Thank you very much.
Y'all come back in the summertime. We have a big one here.
Yeah.
All week long.
Okay. Thank you. She's the one that's just making clothes.
If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer them.
All right. So did that lady travel a lot?
Yes, she did. They went to all 48 states, and they had been to Mexico and had been to... she went to London at her 84th birthday.
Mm-hmm. I guess she would go to fairs and stuff to buy the dolls?
Well, they had to bring back a doll every time they went somewhere, you know.
That's why
we got a lot of the international dolls. And her brothers, she had four brothers, if they were in the service, so she would tell them they couldn't come home unless they brought a doll.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. So, yeah. That's a big collection.
Thank you.
This was your grandmother?
No, she was my husband's aunt.
Your husband's aunt.
Her other sister, that's not pictured here, was her, was my mother-in-law. And we traveled with her a lot. There's a family, like one time there was a family wedding in Colorado.
Yeah.
We took her to Denver, Colorado, to meet up with the family and have a wedding underneath one of the waterfalls out there. The bride came up on a horse.
Huh. Hey, we're riding, I don't know what this is.
I'm vlogging, we're vlogging.
You're vlogging, I'm vlogging.
Vlogging.
Yes. We're going to try to hear me.
What country? Plantation. It's scary. Might see a ghost or two. Hopefully not. But at least I got my camera.
It's really cold to get here, huh?
Yeah. Hey, NASCAR, NASCAR. Yeah.
We're gonna go inside of this house.
Hey.
This is an old house. Is this a Western thing, maybe?
Just the old timey.
Oh.
Before power.
Okay.
Before they invented the light bulb. Yeah.
Hey, how are y'all?
Hello. How are y'all? Do you know when this house was built?
1842.
Wow.
Years ago.
Wow.
Oh,
it's got history.
Ooh. Welcome to the replantation. If y'all have any questions about the house or the family that lived here, please feel free to ask. We'll do our best to answer for you. We do have some candle making demonstrations going out back, and around the corner they're doing blacksmithing, so be sure and see both of those before you head back up. We have some small crafts and small antiques for sale in these two rooms, as well as two novels on the Civil War that I wrote and a modern day Christmas novella, so feel free to browse around. If you find anything you're interested in, I'll be glad to try and help you with them.
All right. Well, thank you.
No problem.
Got a real fire in here going?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Look at the bed.
Father time. They say this is where the ring was came from. Down in the well. Deep well.
I can't believe that they're still preserving this thing.
Yeah.
No power.
No power houses.
It's really cold in here. Like, I think so too.
They slept together.
Approximately 35 times our candles that size. For me, that's a lot of work just to make a few candles. And the other way they might would have made candles was with a candle mold. Now, a candle mold is nothing more than a hollow metal tapered tube. It's got a hole in the bottom of each one of these tubes. What they'll do is feed their wick down from the top through the hole in the bottom and tie it off on the bottom. Then it would anchor that wick to something in the top of the mold to center that wick down the middle of the tube. Pour their hot melted wax in there and let it cool. Now wax, when it cools, it has a tendency to shrink. So when your candles was cold, you should be able to pull them out of the candle mold. I say should, because I occasionally have problems getting candles turned loose of the mold. If I'm doing this at home, a lot of times what I'll do is stick the whole thing in the freezer. Tomorrow morning, my candle's shrunk enough, turn loose the mold, and I can get them out. Mm-hmm.
We do. The husband.
Yeah.
This is nice.
Yeah.
Road
crossing. Rudolph. Rudolph.
What do you call that? The one that we ate?
Cake ball. Goodbye.